show. We're so excited to have you. I'm Camry, and I'm a 26.
I'm Lindsay, and I'm a 26.
And I'm Karina, and I'm also a 26.
Okay, so we're just gonna talk a little bit about Sugar Plum. So, Sugar is Dartmouth's premier contemporary and jazz team founded in 2009. Our dancers have a range of backgrounds from contemporary to ballet to modern to competition dance. Our alumni have gone on to prestigious dance companies across the country and performed at shows such as Crazy Ex-Girlfriend and Love, Simon. This is our spring showcase in which we will showcase some but not all of the dances that we have worked on this year.
So this will be our seniors' last performance of the term. We have Brianna, Rachel, Bella, Emily, and Pam. The 23s have been such role models for us as freshmen. Each and every one of them has made Sugar Plum the incredible community that it is, and we've had the joy of dancing with them for the past year, which is too short, and we will miss them so much.
So, about the show, it consists of three sets with a short 10-minute intermission between each one, followed by a reception in the lobby at the end. And there are booklets in the lobby of the show order, as well as more information about our group and our team. And before we start, we just want to thank Northern Stage and Brian for being so welcoming and accommodating towards our group. So, hope you all enjoy the show.
It's a cold and crazy world that's raging outside. They're really beating on my girls, all bringing on the fight. Show a little leg, gotta shimmy your chest. It's a life, it's a step, it's a need, it's a burlesque. E-X-P-R-E-S-S. Love, sex, ladies, no regrets. E-X-P-R-E-S-S. Love, sex, ladies, no regrets. Thank you.
Oh, Thank you. I like how much of a bad bitch she is.
She is so funny. She just like lights up every single rehearsal.
Like she has such a great dry sense of humor, two cracks of funniest, best jokes.
She has a great way of telling stories. Whether that's just like about herself or things that have happened in the past, she always makes them super entertaining and she's always a joy to talk to.
One of my favorite things about her is her consistent, beautiful athleisure fits at rehearsal. She has the best clothes.
Yes.
I also love how when we're in like the same section, like I can go to you for like help with choreography and then you can admit to me that you don't know it either.
My favorite thing about you, Bella, is your confidence and just your sense of self and ability to be yourself. That's been really inspiring to watch and try to embody for ourselves as freshmen, and we really appreciate all that you've taught us through that.
And I think Bella is just such a thoughtful dancer too. She asks the best questions and she'll like give amazing corrections. She notices so much.
My favorite memory with Bella is anytime I get a confusion with Bella, whether it's like a wholesome dinner or a scorpion bowl in it.
Getting scorpion bowls on Sunday, that was really fun. I feel like that was like the first time I really connected.
I think my favorite memory with Bella, I went to with Bella, but like Max and I planned her entire birthday party and like went to Target and did the whole thing. I think she had a good time. So I think that was definitely.
One of my favorite memories with Bella was like really small, but one of my like first rehearsals with her, everyone was really tired and there was this move where we were like on our knees and she like pulled her sweatshirt over her knees and started like jumping around and I was like, this girl is funny. I was like, this girl is so funny. She gets me.
My favorite memory with you, Bella, is bonding through our love of bombas. I feel like just one day I saw it on your feet and I was like, this is like my person. Bella and I are connected.
Bella's signature move is her extensions. She nails them every time. They are just amazing to watch and I always want to be like her when I see them.
Like
her tilt. Iconic.
I got it.
It's definitely her tilt.
She has such beautiful lines.
Tilt is fire. Yes. The dead man's arms.
It's so good.
Mm-hmm.
Justice.
Side tilt,
side tilt. Yeah. What will I miss most? Well, I frequently somehow run into you on the way to practice, and I will miss fast speed walking to rehearsal because, quote, I'm never late.
It's like, she's so down to earth, and I feel like she just brings such a good energy because of that.
And I just want to say, Bella, thank you for being such a welcoming person into Sugar and being so kind.
I'll just miss having Bella in rehearsal. I feel like she's just such a good presence in the studio. Like she has like funny clips on the side or just seeing her dance.
I'd like to say that I'm really grateful to have you in Sugar. You definitely lighten up every rehearsal. And also, I feel like whenever I've like needed something, you're always the first one that's eager to help. And I really appreciate that.
She really is so genuine in how she approaches like Sugar and all of her relationships with us.
We'll really miss your humor. And just like the dry little jokes you make. It always makes my day better.
It's just great being around her and I don't know, just her presence is what I think I'm gonna miss most.
I cannot wait to see all the incredible things we will do after graduating.
We love you. Love you,
Bella.
My favorite thing about Brie is that she's a go-getter. She'll put her mind to something and she'll get it done.
My favorite thing about Brie is just like how much she loves Sugar and how much she's invested in Sugar.
Beginning even during COVID, she made me feel like I was part of the group and that was amazing.
My favorite thing about you is just how willing you are to extend the Sugar community outside of the studio, whether it's meeting with me about your thesis for my article or sitting with me at Stillmore. Really make Sugar a home outside of rehearsal.
How genuinely caring and kind she is to literally anyone and everyone that she crosses paths.
Maria's just so supportive. She's like a collective mom. Like, I was choreographing for the first time this term, and Bree was just so nice about it, like making sure I had everything I needed, like making sure that I got everything across that I needed to. It was just like a great experience, and she made that happen.
Favorite memory with this person?
My favorite memory, I wasn't originally gonna audition for Sugar, but I was friends with her little sister, and so Kayla was like, you should audition for Sugar. I didn't know where Sugar auditions were being held. I knew that it was at Sarner, but it was like my second week at school. So I didn't know where Sarner was. Bree sent me a picture of like her hand pointing to Sarner. It was a really funny picture, but I also thought it was so helpful. It was so funny.
Oh, my favorite memory will be of you and Alpha Kai screaming, Sugar Plum! I love the video of it. It was so funny. We were a line of girls in bikinis walking around like a crowded house.
Us being in Alpha Kai, and she's like, Queen and I really needed to go to the bathroom, and she's like fighting these brothers to let us go use the restroom upstairs. It was really sweet.
My favorite memory of Hungary is, more generally, your home, Dollhouse. We loved it there, and we loved the community that was created in there, like from pasta knives to like the little frog joke.
When she got coffee with me at Still North, and we like talked about things, and she was just very supportive and caring in general, and I really appreciated that from her.
One of my favorite memories is actually just the Rachel lift in Ashley's dance. You just let Rachel stand on your shoulders, and then not only that, we went to Beta and the ceiling wasn't tall enough. You're like, okay, I'll just squat.
Yeah, let's pop a super here. Three was the really ratchet formal that she hosted in her house.
Yeah.
Our freshman year, which is still one of the most fun Sugar memories, mm-hmm. like social memories ever.
My favorite memory with Bree, it's really simple, but we were just walking back from practice, and I don't know, I just had a lot on my mind, a lot of things I have to do after class. But Bree just puts me in a better mood, and she just asks me like how my day is going, and just wants to get to know me better. And I just really enjoy like being able to talk to someone about things and have someone who's genuinely interested in what I'm doing, who I am as a person. And yeah, she just lifted me up in that moment.
Her signature move is like thinking that ball's like grabbing your heart, like taking a breath.
Yeah, oh yeah, I like the way.
She's so good at the big dramatic short movements. I could watch her do that all day. She's so good at it.
It's probably the knee drop. She goes super high and she slays every time. No questions asked. I don't know which it hurts, but she doesn't show it.
I'll just miss how fun Bree is. She always makes socials a good time, practice a good time.
Just her presence, having her in the room. She's so warm, she's so friendly.
She does a really good job of just like making it more than just a dance group, but making it such like a social and like community space.
You have made Sugar honestly home.
Most incredible human being out there. I wouldn't be who I am today without you, and I'm so happy and grateful that dance and Dartmouth has brought us together.
Thank you, Bree. You're amazing. I can only imagine that you'll make an impact on other people like me in your future, and I'm gonna really miss you.
You're such a role model to me, and I can't wait to see what you do.
Yeah, I think you're gonna go off to do great things.
Mm-hmm. We love you, Bree! Oh my goodness!
Storm, and I'm caught up in. on. There is a light in the dark, and I feel its warmth in my hands, in my heart. Why can't I hold on? It comes and goes in waves, it always does, always does. We watch as our young hearts fade into the fire.
Where do we go? Acercarte
She's just always been super kind to me and reached out in the sweetest ways. I just feel super comfortable being around her. She's so easygoing.
She just radiates chill and calmness.
She has so much chill. I wish I could have as much chill as her.
And she's just so down to earth. I don't know.
That Emily's just like such a chill, gives no F's kind of person.
My favorite memory with Emily Hester was in the winter. We went to Han Fujin, and I realized that night that you were just like secretly one of the funniest people ever. In your quiet, sneaky way, you were hysterical.
I love how I can just look at you during rehearsal and we'll both start laughing. It is so funny.
So many amazing memories with her. She really tied with my friends, like back in my freshman year when we weren't even on campus, to like meet up and do these really cute coffee dates, and really just made me feel part of the Sugar community.
Yeah.
I think my favorite memory is either when she taught her celeb, which was a beautiful dance, and like that's when I got to see really the full extent of what an amazing dancer she is, but also every time we work at the cafe together, I really enjoy because she's so nice to talk to and she just makes it a lot better.
One of my favorite memories is we went Halloween costume shopping together and she wanted to be Shrek, and literally all she did was go and buy a green tank top, and she didn't end up being Shrek. She always wears to rehearsal and it reminds me that she was going to be Shrek.
Emily's signature is anything related to ballet. Her ballet technique is actually out of this world.
I feel like one of the most beautiful dancers I've ever seen in, like, ever in my entire life.
I remember during the first show, you were turning those turns, and I was like, damn, let's go up and turn.
I do remember that.
And I was like, wow, the technique.
And she does awesome turns, but in, like, a very specific way, with, like, her arms and her leg, and, like, it's very, like, rushed. And very fast, and very like Russian Bolshoi ballet. You can tell she spent a year in Russia, and that's just iconic.
I think what I'll miss most about M. Hest, as silly and fun and amazing as you are, you're also like one of the kindest people I know. Like, you have a really sweet soul, and you're always willing to help out or like go over choreo on the side or just give us life advice.
I feel like she's someone you can kind of just like be like, hey, are you down for this? And she's like, yeah, I'm down for it.
One thing that I want to tell Emily Hester that I haven't had a chance to say is she's literally one of the coolest people on campus, and not enough people realize that.
Thank you for all you've done for Sugar and making practice such a fun place to be every day.
I just look up to Emily so much. Like, she's such a role model for me.
Just providing like mentorship and advice on like certain areas of my life where I was struggling, which like you had, like which you could relate to, was really, really welcoming and very, very needed at that moment. And I really, really appreciate it. And I don't think I ever like properly thanked you for the impact that had on me. So thank you.
I like wish I had more time to spend with her and get to know her even better. But I'm really excited for all the like exciting things that's gonna come in her life.
What would we do without Pam?
I would not be the same without Pam.
My favorite thing about Pam is that she is just the absolute kindest soul you'll ever meet. Whenever I say hi to her, whenever I see her, she always has like the sweetest smile.
My favorite thing about you is how responsible you are. I don't think Sugar would run as smoothly as it did without your leadership.
She's just such a solid person. And she's so kind, and she's really funny, but not intentionally funny.
She's also just so loving. I feel like, I don't know, she's always like got that really sweet smile, and she just like makes you feel happy.
Yeah, and you can like go to her for anything.
Yeah.
My favorite thing about Pam is that she's super kind and inclusive. She knows how to level with people and make sure that they feel welcome.
How kind and gentle and reliable she is. I feel like I can trust her with anything. That's something I really value in a person.
My favorite thing about you, Pam, and this is going to be so niche, is when you run back and forth to play the music and you can enjoy the dance. Somehow, that is just like ingrained in my head.
She does it all.
Perfect. You do it all.
One of my favorite things about her is how fun she is, especially like on a night out. She is so fun to go out with. Like, I remember after like Sugar Circuit, we just stayed out together in this random pod of Sugars, and it was such a fun time.
My favorite memory with Pam is my freshman year, back when everything was locked down and it was COVID, so we were not even dancing. I went on a Zoom Sugar date with Pam and a couple of other people who played Among Us together.
I remember seeing her at the Barn Babies event in college and just getting to chill with her at the bunnies and just be present with her.
My favorite memory of you is probably when you choreographed the forms of your dance on your like your tax paper.
Kind of a funny memory.
Yeah, okay. A funny memory is, this is our freshman fall. She choreographed a dance and she forgot to put herself in it. And we didn't realize until our like last run through.
Yeah, she was like, this pyramid has everyone in it. And then she wasn't in it. And we're like, wait, where do you go? She goes, oh, I think I forgot to put myself in it.
I listened to you at the tilt. Her hips and her legs, you didn't notice that mine can't remind me of the world. And her lines are always so beautiful.
The side tilt.
Yeah, definitely her
that
tilt.
Is
yeah, signature move, tilts.
Yeah.
Duh. She has gorgeous lines and so much strength to be able to hold her leg all the way up there.
Like, I think the first video I ever saw of Pam was like her doing the tilt, and I think it was like nails,
yes,
or whatever. I guess
on
like
it.
A jaw dropping.
Oh, Miss Mess, Pam's smile, her gentle smile. I literally brightens my day up every single time.
Really gonna miss your choreography.
Pam's dances hit different.
Yeah,
they're just so powerful.
She's such like a staple of Sugar Plum for me, and I just like can't imagine a Sugar Plum without Pam.
One thing that I wish I have been able to say to Pam is that I'm just really impressed with how she's been able to grow and go out of her comfort zone, speak out, and not be afraid to like tell us to get going on warm-up or on the choreo.
Thank you for all the work you do in Sugar. Mm-hmm. I think a lot of it just kind of flies under our radar and goes a little bit unrecognized. But we like are so grateful for all the hard work that you always put in. You are like the glue that keeps us together and keeps the machine
running.
Absolutely.
I'm just really good at this pack. I love
you, Pam.
My favorite thing about Miss Rachel is her mentorship, which is a crazy word to say. But like, we would have these amazing dinners with Rachel where she would tell us a story about her life and like give us advice and just honestly guide us through being people.
My favorite thing about Rachel is that she is super focused and motivated to become a better dancer. She's always looking for new ways to create movement, just to be unique in her expression of herself.
One of my favorite things about Rachel is just like how genuine and cool she is. I feel like she's so true to herself, and I love that.
My favorite thing about Rachel is just everything she has to say. She always has something funny or interesting or about her past experiences to add to a conversation. So it always makes talking with her super duper fun.
My favorite thing about Rachel is how fearless she is. She's never scared to show who she is. You can never see the tribal things and how to meet new people. It's something I really love to
do. Favorite thing about Rachel too is that like we are constantly late to DVD together, just like always later than we should be.
My favorite memory of Rachel is just every time we go to the club and end up being at our bus lock dinner of just past stories from her time at college or just her telling us about her life and random experiences, and it's always been a really good time.
My favorite memory is that night when we sat on Collis Porch for 3.5 hours, and we were just telling stories all night, particularly your Uber stories.
Rachel and I went back to the library and just like sat on 2FB and talked till like 2 or 3 in the morning. And that really helped make Sugar a community a lot like quicker than it would have otherwise.
I remember one time in the winter we went to rehearsal and no one was there. And it was during the Sugar photo shoot, so we just went back and met up with, I think like Pam and Connie were the two Sugars left at the photo shoot, and we just took a bunch of photos in the tower room. It was really fun.
I just remember having this like really deep conversation about dance and like dance theory and all of this stuff and like why we love styles and our experiences, and it was just so cool, and I remember thinking, damn, that girl's really cool.
Yeah.
She basically taught me how to play better palm, so thank you, Rachel. I'm so proud of my palm from this moment forward because of you.
Rachel's signature move is probably doing the elbow stand with her legs in a double stab. She's always in the back doing that.
The head thing. She doesn't get just got good head isolation.
Signature move, definitely floor. Yes. So
anything like face down, legs up.
Yes.
Floor.
There's this floor that can be so twist. It is one of the snakes here.
Has this really cool like sideways like front handspring sort of thing. Like I can't even describe it, but it's just so athletic and effective, and I think that's probably your signature move.
Yeah. Wait, can I demonstrate her signature?
Wait, I'm going to demonstrate her signature.
She's doing the back bendy crazy.
We'll see so, in crazy.
In crazy, yeah.
Where
yeah,
it's like a back, it's like a flip.
Yeah.
All this is all of the conversations we've had, and all this her being in rehearsal and talking about the angry bird calls that she knows, that she memorized when she was younger and knows how to do.
Your talent. The way you move and your movement quality is just so unique. And it really just elevates Sugar, and I don't know what we're gonna do without it.
Her choreography, that was something that both of us agreed on. Yeah. She has like super unique choreographies. I just really look up to Rachel so much. I think that, yeah, she's just been like such a role model for me.
Yeah.
And Sugar, and dancing.
Rachel, you're such a boss. You're literally gonna rule the world one day, and I can't wait to see you do it.
Only I would know. Ooh, why didn't you kiss me? Thought it'd be my last. Oh, Lord.
tears, but I know you hear my tears, crying to the blindest eyes, but I know you see the light, that's you.
So you don't have to find the borderline to when the moment comes, you'll say.
Does it turn on?
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Emily.
I'm Annabella.
And I'm Olivia.
To close off our show, we would like to show our love to each of our seniors. The first being Bella. Do we have Bella, we will miss your silly facials, dry humor, and fantastic style in the studio. Next, we have Brianna. Bree, we'll miss your infectious laugh, strong leadership, and thorough warm-ups at the beginning of every round. Next up, we have Emily Hester. Emily, your insane extensions, your kindness inside and outside the studio, and your hilarious stories. We love you. And then Pam, we'll miss your amazing choreography and your care for each and every one of us, and of course, your tilt.
And last but not least, we have Rachel. Rachel, we will miss your sweat scarf. We're gonna miss your rather unfortunate Uber stories, and of course, we'll miss your impromptu headstands in the back. We'd like to welcome everyone to a reception in the lobby after this. Thank you, guys.